Hi, I'm Bogdan from DNN Sharp. In this video, I want to show you how you can subscribe users to MailChimp using action form. And this can happen two ways. You can have the standard, the classic subscribe to newsletter form, or you can incorporate this as a step in a bigger process, for example, in the registration form. And I will cover both of these in this video. But before moving on, I want to mention that this MailChimp integration was part of ActionForm in past releases, but then we've taken it out to enhance it further, and we're also implementing other integrations with other email marketing providers such as Campaign Monitor or Constant Contact. So now you have three options to choose from. So enough talking. I would go to a new page that I've already created. And on this site, I already have installed Action Form and the add-on for the MailChimp integration. So I will just add a new Action Form module to the page. And then on the startup screen, you will find a template to subscribe to MailChimp. And I will use this. And it will create for me the first name, the last name, and the email field. These are the almost simplest setup that you can have. The most simple one is that you could only have the email address. So that's the only required field to subscribe to a newsletter. And let's look a little bit at what this template created for us. So we have these basic fields, and then we have this subscribe button. If we expand it, we can see the on-click handler has two actions. It has the subscribe to MailChimp action and a display confirmation message action. So if we expand the subscribe to MailChimp action, you'll see that we need to configure it with an API key and a list name. And I already created a free account on MailChimp. So the first thing, we would need to get an API key. And you can get an API key by clicking your name here, going to account settings, and then under extras, you find the API keys section. I don't have any API keys yet, so I'm creating one now. And I will copy it in the clipboard and use it in my action. And then I need a list name. Let's go back, go under lists, and we don't have any list, but we can create one. Let's call it newsletter. I'm just saving this. There are some required fields here. Let's try it now. You're subscribing to a test list. Okay, so now we have this new newsletter list, and we'd just type it here. And keep an eye open for spelling errors, like I just did one. Okay, the rest is just choosing an email field, because if you have a bigger form, you could have multiple email fields, so you can choose which one to use for subscribing. And then we pass additional data such as first name and last name fields. And this is it. Let's save this form and demonstrate it real quickly. So let me just subscribe a new user. And I will put an email address, and I will click subscribe. So now I should be subscribed. Let's refresh this page. The list still says that I have zero subscribers, but if I drill down in the list, It will probably show me, yes, it will show me the subscriber, so it has a refresh issue and you should keep an eye open to this also. So now I have my first subscriber. That was pretty easy, I would say. And now let's go back and do another form, which is a registration form. Okay, and we'll start with the standard registration form that's provided as the template that creates everything for us. And I'd say let's just add a checkbox to subscribe to newsletter. Subscribe to newsletter. Okay, so this is a checkbox. I should see where it's placed, so I should place it maybe just above the buttons. And then I would need to add an action under register button, where you can see I already have user registration, a profile update, user login. And then at the end, I want to choose an action, and it's located under email, to subscribe to MailChimp. So now it's the same action that you've seen earlier, only I use it in a different context. And you can also drag this action and choose where the order were to happen. This right now it doesn't matter that much, only that if I execute it last, if any of this action throws an error, it doesn't get to this form, so it doesn't subscribe a user that would eventually have a failed registration. So it's good that is last. So I have again to use the API key. And then I would have to type the list name, which is newsletter, choose the email field, and I'm done. I will not do anything else. I could also pass the first name, the last name, and as a matter of fact, I could pass any custom data, because you can just go into a list and you can edit it in order to create custom fields. Yes, so you can add any number of fields and just pass data from your portal into the MailChimp list. So you can use it, for example, when creating email templates, but I will not create any fields now. I'll just go back, and I need to wire this action, subscribe to MailChimp. I need to wire it to the checkbox. So when the checkbox is ticked, will this action execute? And to do this, I will just grab the ID of the checkbox and use it as a token in the condition for the action here. And this condition is basically a Boolean expression that tells either this action will execute or not. And this is a Boolean expression because it's a checkbox. If it was something else, like a text box, it would be a string, and I would have to use an operator such as equal operator to compare it to something. This would create an equal operator, a Boolean expression, which is either true or false, depending on the equality. But in this case, I could write something like this. If subscribe to newsletter equals true. But this happens implicitly. Okay. So now I will save and I will go back and try to create a new user. Let's call this user James. And I will use a different email address. And then I will tick the subscribe to newsletter checkbox. And now I'm registering. So the page refreshed. I'm already registered, logged in as this user. And now I will go to to my list and check that I have the new user. So as you can see, this new user has just appeared in the list. So you see, I think that was very simple to do, and think about the flexibility that you have here just using this action, not just as a simple subscribe to newsletter form, but as part of other more complex processes. I hope this helped, and thank you for your time.